Hey guys, Downphoenix here. We're back to play some Splatoon. But this time we are going to be checking out the SP. Yes, there is an SP mode. Single player. I already talked to this guy, but yeah. So we're going to go ahead and check stuff out. And I've got my machine splat gun. Plus a VLVs, I suppose. And I have to save some Zapfish. Apparently. Oh, I gotta actually go in. I think? We'll find out. I don't know. I've never done this SP before, so I don't know what the point of it is. Other than to shoot stuff, you know, like in the actual game. Okay, I guess I can shoot these for power-ups and whatnot, so we'll go ahead and check that out. Nice, that was awesome. That worked quite well, actually. Let's move up this, though. Yeah, that's very interesting. A little bit of a stealth element to it. Because you have to kind of make sure to get enemies off guard and stuff like that. That's pretty cool. So yeah, Splatoon is definitely a very multiplayer-focused game, but the single player is supposed to be pretty interesting from what I understand. I don't know how accurate that is, but we're gonna check that out. And if you like what you see, of course, we're gonna cover more of that eventually. But I guess this is supposed to maybe help you in some manner of, just helping you play the game and stuff like that. And I never even bothered playing this before. I just figured that the single player was stupid, and it probably is. But we're still gonna play it. So I just wanted to see what they had planned for it, you know, and see what, like, the boss fights and stuff like that are. Let's see. So, oh, we got some enemies. Let's Splatoon them. There we go. Oh, I guess those were, like, experience points or something, I'm guessing, that I'm getting from them. Let's shoot this up. You can't hurt these fellas. Maybe I can. Or I guess I can, I guess, actually. Wait. What am I supposed to do then? Okay. I guess I just go around it. Oh, and I see he's, like, cleaning it up. He's mopping it up. Okay, so I guess we have to go this way. So I don't know if those things are supposed to be, like, spawn points, possibly, or something. There we go. That's what I'm thinking. That's where I think we started at. There we go. So now we've got to use our little tricks to maneuver our way around. Very clever use of gameplay techniques. So here we go. Let's DL that. And this kind of has a bit of a Mario Galaxy feel to it, honestly. You know, with, like, a lot of short little zone areas that you can go through. And you kind of just go from zone to zone. Really interesting. There we go. Armor. Sweet, I've got armor. That's right. We are armored up now. Okay. I guess it's okay to stand on top of these? I suppose? I don't know. It looks like. Get on top of this so we can get our stuff more easily. There we go. Nice. That's how we got to do that. Use X to climb faster. I always forget to do that. Okay. Checkpoint. Yay! That is really fun. Okay. And that was really easy, but I'm sure it'll get more challenging as we go along. In fact, I have no idea how long the multiplayer is even supposed to be. I imagine it's probably not very long, a couple of hours. Since it is, you know, not the main focus of the game. Which is really interesting because, like, a lot of Nintendo titles have pretty robust single-player modes. Even the ones that are multiplayer-focused games. But it seems like they've kind of changed that recently, because, like, with the most new Smash Bros., for instance, it doesn't have an actual, thing. Okay. It's easier to climb if you're looking up. Okay. I suppose it is, but why would I look up when climbing? That doesn't make sense. That is so silly to do. I know there's, like, that portal thing, but I'm sure there's gotta be a reason to do it this way that I'm doing it right now, right? Well, screw it. Lose the portal. Use the portal. Final checkpoint? Aha! Ink cannon. Much better. Much better indeed. That is awesome sauce. Okay. And I guess I'm supposed to just drop down? Yeah, I suppose. Okay, let's go up then. Let's hurry up before he cleans up everything. There we go. Much better, much better. And I guess this will do it. We got the little fish. The zap fish. Okay. Awesome. Much better. Okay, so, I guess now that we did that, that's one zap fish. Let's go ahead and grab another over here. There we go. From what I understand, single player doesn't unlock anything from multiplayer except for some basic gear, which that's fine. I don't really expect it to unlock a bunch of stuff. I don't know if the one I played was supposed to be easier or harder than the one I'm doing now, because this was the first one that I encountered, so I just didn't realize you're supposed to go inside it, so I'm sure it probably is easier. There we go. Got the checkpoint. Oh, they got a shield! I guess I gotta sneak around. I said it's got a bit of a stealth element to it. Just a bit. Just a tiny bit. Move on to the next little tiny thing here. You know, actually it makes me wonder. I almost have a feeling that maybe this game could have been like another Super Mario Sunshine game. In a way. Or something like that. I don't know. Because there had been rumors that Nintendo was making a Super Mario Sunshine game. I've heard them before. I don't know how legitimate they are, but this game makes me think that's definitely a possibility. There we go, that's much better. Okay. Now we can teleport our way out. I don't know, I don't think it matters that I ink everything. This isn't Turf War after all. This is just Save the Universe War. Oh yeah, bombs, okay. Much better. Bombs away. Got him. Or got him, I guess you could say, right? This is just to reinforce what you've learned just now. There we go. But that's okay. That's okay. We don't need to reinforce that. I already know what I'm doing here, game. I think it's pretty abundantly clear. Okay. There we go. Much better, much better. You guys suck at this game. They play like some of my teammates. Haha, just kidding. I got hit, actually. I guess I'm the one that sucks. Okay. Let's go ahead and grab this stuff here. Bam. Seems pretty simple, just shoot, shoot, shoot. And obviously you want to not walk in the green stuff because it slows you down and stuff, you know, just like in the actual multiplayer game. There we go. The only thing that really makes me upset about Splatoon is the lack of any local multiplayer that's good. There's a dojo mode, but it's only one versus one. It's just not that good. It would have been much better had they had like a split-screen multiplayer mode of some type. And yeah, that just would have been better, without a doubt. Let's see. Actually, I guess I'm supposed to go this way? Okay, there it is. I'm supposed to go up here, I guess. Yes, nice. Okay. Look for the key. That works out pretty nicely. Agent 3, so where's 1 and 2 then? Where are 1 and 2? Who does number 1 and 2 work for? That's pretty bad. There we go. And I think that's... Bust in and grab it. Yes, we saved the fish. Another fish be saved. Arg. Okay, so we're going to check out the upgrades here. Because I apparently have upgrades I can do. Let's check those out. Okay. Oh, I need a bunch of stuff. Okay. Let's increase the ink tank capacity then. I think that'd be a good idea. Okay. There we go. We'll just stick with that for now. And save the rest for the other stuff, you know. Okay. Is this where I need to go? Need more zapfish. Okay. I know that they are like little hidden portal thingies, so I just need to look for something that looked like that. Okay, it's gotta be up there. Yep, there it is. Much better. Let's go in. Okay, so this will be level 3, I suppose. I guess this game has a very simple mission structure. It'd be nice if you can choose the colors of your ink. Maybe you can later on here. Swimming in squid now form. Okay. There we go. Yeah, it's, I like this mode so far. It's pretty nice and simple. It's a shame that it doesn't have a lot more to it from what I understand, but I'm digging it. Let's see. Oh, there we go. Let's just make our jump. Got it. Some squid platforming action. I think one thing that could be cool in the multiplayer mode is to have, like, enemy AIs. Like, how we have here. You know, randomly appear in the game. Okay. So there's an ink rail. Oh, okay, nice, nice. That would have been sweet to have, too. A little way to kind of, like, rappel along the ink rope. Inkity inkity. There we go. And I don't think there's anything over there. Try not to miss anything important. Inkzooka, heck yeah, let's ready that bad boy. Nice. I inked him well. So I guess you gotta pick up the power-ups in the single player. Okay, let's get rid of those octocopters. There we go. I don't know why I would be getting rid of those, though. Aren't they my allies? I would think so. Octos. We're octos, right? There we go, let's jump over. Attack from behind, huh? That sounds pretty good. Come on, get up there. That's right. It is my time to ruin the party for you. Nice, nice, very nice. Let's mark our checkpoint. Crap. Yeah. No harm, no foul, I suppose. I guess really the ink doesn't kill you, surprisingly. Well, it was easy to kill. It only took like three little blasts. There we go, much better. Now we found our fish and we can get out of here. Okay, so I guess collecting the power-ups give me a little bit of extra red dots to boost up my stuff. Okay. Sunken scrolls, what's that do? Okay. Okay, let's just go ahead and go to the boss kettle. Oh. Oh, this is the boss kettle. Got it. So now it's time to fight our first boss. Ooh. I'm sure this will be tricky. Let's see here. Reset camera. Yeah, that sounds good. Nice big ol' arena. I'll take that. Ooh, here comes the boss. Oh no, poor Zapfish. Tiny little fish hidden inside of a light bulb. Ooh, we got a giant purple block. Oh no. Okay, let's climb our way up, I think, or I don't know, I suppose. Nice, that's it. That's the ticket. Alright, giant purple block, it's time for you to face some more Amiya. Yeah, I've seen this boss fight before, so I already know what to do. It's a bit of a cheat, but I mean, I think pretty much anybody that's been interested in the game, this is like one of the first clips that they saw of the game. I know it's one of the first clips that I saw before the game came out. Uh-oh, we got moving panels now. This will be tough to do, guys. I can promise you that. Oh, crap. Crap. Didn't have enough time. But at least we're inked up, so... go, we're inked up. Crap. I don't got a lot of time here. Okay, I'm just gonna have to be quicker about it, I suppose. There we go. Holy crap. That is not enough time. Okay. I'll get better at this, though. Crap, why is it... Whoa, that was like half the time that I had last time for it. Sure seemed like it, anyways. Okay, there we go. Made it! Wonder if that's the last hit. I think it is. Yeah, that's it. That last little bit was kind of challenging, but he didn't really pose a threat. Either. I guess he could have possibly crushed us, but I didn't see it. There's a scroll. Let's grab that. Wonder if that's anything. Should find out. Nope. I thought it was, but guess not. Onward. Okay. We'll do that then. So I guess that beats the first little world. They have a great octo-weapons on their side. At any rate, good work, Agent 3. Keep it up, it's a long road to the great Zapfish. Yeah. Sorry that I skipped the opening cutscene from earlier, because I accidentally launched this, so... Okay. Yeah, pretty simple. Let's move on and... Yep, we got our extension cords hooked up. Don't try that at home, kids. That could be dangerous. There we go.